Hello, welcome to RS Walker State Park. Today we're going to be talking about cat faces. As you hike the trails here at R. Walker, you'll notice some scars on the trees. Those scars are the result of the turpentine or the gum naval stores industry. The tar from these trees were collected, cooked down, and turned into pitch. The pitch was used to waterproof the wooden ships of the day. The men would take a chipping tool, remove a certain depth and a certain width of the bark, causing the tree to bleed. Then they would take a cup axe, cut a hole in the base of the tree to serve as a cup to catch the tar. The problem with that is, this big a cut in the tree would kill the tree. Dead trees don't produce much pine tar. So in 1901, a chemist from the University of Georgia by the name of Charles Hurdy came up with the idea of hanging a clay pot on the tree and then nailing metal gutters above the cup to channel the tar into the cup. This proved to be a much more efficient way to collect the tar and was a whole lot less traumatic to the trees. The method used today is the same one that's used in the sugar maple industry. A small hole is drilled into the tree, a piece of pipe is driven up into the tree part of the way, the plastic bag is tied to the end of the pipe, and the tar is collected in the bag. Again, a whole lot more efficient, a whole lot less traumatic. So where did this term cat face come from? Well, as the men would chip the tree, they would cut grooves in the face, and this would cause the tar to be channeled down the tree into the cup. To them, those grooves look like the whiskers on a cat's face. The top of the cup then, being in the shape of a V, looked like the pointed ears of a cat. Thus, the term cat face. Well, there's much more to learn about the turpentine or the gum naval stores industry, and a few interesting facts about Mr. Hurdy himself. So I invite you back to R. Walker State Park as soon as you can in the near future, and until then, be safe.